What's up, everybody? This is Carolina Mike, your host for SharePoint in 60 Seconds. Stick around to find out how you can bring together a whole bunch of calendars into one single web part and see all the events at one time in 60 seconds. Stay tuned.
I'm a SharePoint expert, play with data extra. Careful with my hands, cause I gotta use them for work. Yeah, I'm a big old nerd. I like maple syrup. All my pancakes, I don't care what you heard.
And we're back. First and foremost, thank you to all 1,090 subscribers. That's right, we hit the 1,000 mark this year. Give yourself a big round of applause. Appreciate you. All right. Please like, please subscribe. If you feel like this can help somebody, please share it. And all funds earned from this channel will go towards paying my student loans. So it's a win-win-win. Let's get it. So first thing you're going to do is you're going to go inside and you're going to make sure that you create a basic SharePoint calendar, okay? You may have to go into the classic app center to do that, but you can do it. And you go add your events to that. And then you go to the page where you want to do that. Well, first you make a whole bunch of calendars, as many as you want. Then you're going to go wherever you want to see all those events rolled into one little nice little package. Just go to a page, edit that page, and add the events web part, and then clicky, 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 and then you got a whole bunch of stuff you can see all at once. Boom. Now, stick around, and we're going to actually walk right through it. We're going to get right to it. Wow. Let me breathe here. Whew. By the way, if you have pumpkins sitting out, watch out for the squirrels. This thing here did have teeth, but yeah, squirrel took hold of it. All right, so here we go. So let's say you are on a site and you need to keep track of like separate calendars, right? So every site by default is going to have one calendar here, okay? So at least the hub site will, or excuse me, communication site will. And so if I go to site contents, I'm going to see at least one events. It's just going to be called events. That's the default name. That's the one you get when you get a brand new site. And so let's say you got events there, but then you need another calendar, right? And so we would go in and we would just say new here, a new app, right? And we do have this new thingy. This is not the way it used to be. This changed, I don't know, a few months ago, I guess. So you click on classic experience and then you should have access to the calendar. Boom, it's old school. It's not going to be in the modern experience, but it does work with the modern event web part to a large extent. So we'll call this, Carolina Panthers. And so now we got this other calendar, okay? And we could have a bunch more calendars. So let's go to that calendar. And I do have a bunch more calendars, but let's go. The key here is to add some events to this thing. And it helps to make the events like in the future so that they show up in the default web part. So we're just going to add, a couple of things here. Okay. And then boom, boom, boom. And we save it. So we have something on there. Okay. So we know that's on that calendar. And we could create more, but I'm just going to go with this one and you'll get the idea. So right now we're going to go back to the homepage. And we've got this default web part down here that we're going to start to modify. But if you didn't have it, you would just click edit. And you would go in and you would add, I'll just add it here just for giggles. You add the event web part. Where is it? It's in here somewhere. Oh my gosh, there it is, events. And it just automatically pulled that in. But I'm going to show you how to configure this in just a second. And really, we're just going to, whatever. We'll leave this one alone. This is the default one, but we'll just work with this one. Okay, things shift, things change. Stick with me. Here we go. So basically what it did is it went ahead and grabbed everything. Let's see what it grabbed before I start just making judgments here. So the source is set for all sites in the hub. Now this is a brand new web part that I just added, and I'm going to go on a limb and say this is the default all sites in the hub. Now this is a communication site that's a hub site that does have some associated sites, so it's looking out at all of those sites, all of their calendars, and pulling in every event, but I don't have anything out there in those other calendars. Okay. You can trim to category if you want. There's a whole bunch of settings you can do here. Maybe I'll do another video, but it's just, there's a lot, but let's focus on the source and we can deal with the other stuff later. So all sites in the hub, you could say events list on this site. And this one here, if I go events list on this site, it's going to make me pick one. All right. It's not combining them. It's going to make me pick one and go with that. Okay. We have this site. And so here you're not seeing anything combined because there are other calendars, but there's no events on there. So why don't we go ahead and just save this as a draft for now. And then we're going to make sure that it's pulling in from other calendars. So we're going to go site contents, take a look at some of these other calendars. We'll go to the default calendar, just events. And we'll add something else in the future here so that we can see the functionality. Come on, there we go. We'll say, I'm just making up stuff. I don't have time to think about what I'm typing here. I just want to type something. Go. All right, there we go. Now let's go back to the home page and let's see what we got. Ooh, is it taking some time to sync up? Here, let's see. Let's go check our settings here. So we're going to edit and we're going to see what we are. What's our source? Okay. So this should be pulling. Oh, there it is. Wow. Okay. Looking over here and it popped up. So there you go. So that's proof that it's pulling in from two different calendars. We could take a peek at the other options real quick and then we can release you back into the wilderness where you shall prosper and spread the joy of SharePoint. All right. All sites in the hub, we talked about that. This site collection, you know, if you had subsites, which nobody's building subsites these days, well, I guess maybe some, but try to stay away from them. But if you had subsites and sub-subsites or whatnot, it would pull events from all those calendars as well. I don't know if it goes down more than one level or not. I haven't tested that. If anyone knows, let me know in the comments. We talked about all sites in the hub. We have all sites. This would be all sites throughout your whole, like, your whole tenant, like your whole installation. That's just crazy that it can pull calendar events from, like, across the whole tenant. All right. I'm freaking out about that. Or you can select sites. And then if you select a site, it's going to pull all the calendars from that site. So, you know, if you want me to go into any more gory detail about some of these other things, I'm happy to do that. I feel like, you know, the purpose of this video is show you how to basically combine a bunch of different calendars that live on a single site into one events web part. And we did that. So if you want to see more, let me know in the comments. Please like and subscribe. I wish you all the best. Take it easy. Keep smiling and do the things that make you happy. Until next time, this is Carolina Mike saying SharePoint rocks. And so do you. Take it easy, y'all. I'm a SharePoint expert. Play with data extra. Careful with my